my cancer story 20 years ago today. August 13th, 1999.
It was around this time that I stopped eating. And even though I had been eating a specialized diet where they were trying to reduce the risk of infection and the hospital food wasn't that great and I was nauseous, it was really this time that I could no longer eat. And that's because I had developed mouth sores. This is a common side effect oftentimes of chemotherapy treatment. And I wish I would have listened to the nurses, because what one of the nurses said to another nurse while they were in my room during my first few days was, it's interesting that her doctor didn't prescribe her antibacterial mouthwash. And I didn't really think anything of it. I didn't even think to question the doctor or ask why or if I should be on antibacterial mouthwash considering the treatment I was about to undergo. And those mouth sores were so bad, pretty much for a few days, I just drank water. The medical team was really concerned because I wasn't eating. My weight started decreasing, and not in a positive way. I was losing not only fat, but muscle mass as well. I was extremely weak because I wasn't consuming really any calories. And that's when I had to turn to Ensure. And this is somewhat controversial. I know sometimes for people who have cancer treatment and cancer therapy of what we should eat and what we shouldn't eat. But at the time, I needed to do what was best. And what was best was drinking something that was available, that wouldn't cause a greater infection, and that could give me some calories. And that's the only thing that would work. And I couldn't even drink it normal. I had to drink it very slow, because any time I move my mouth, whether it be to talk, to try to smile, chew, which was the worst, or even swallow, that would cause so much pain that's why I stopped eating. So doing what we have to do at that point in time, what is best for us at that point in time, is so important, knowing we can make changes in the future.
August 13th, 2019.
Today I'm a vegan. That means I really consume no animal products, and this was a conscious choice I made. Oftentimes people say that I have a dietary restriction because I choose to be vegan, and I definitely don't have a dietary restriction. A dietary restriction, on the other hand, is when I was undergoing my chemotherapy treatment and I had to be on a specialized diet to reduce the risk of infection. And there's a whole bunch of other reasons oftentimes why people may have dietary restrictions. And so a question I oftentimes get is, how can you be a vegan? Aren't you so deprived? Don't you miss food?
Nope, the food I eat is delicious.
And that's why I recently did a video on why I chose to go vegan. Because this is what I feel right now is what I need to do to support my health and wellness. And between 20 years ago to where I am today, I've continued to make small adjustments, both in my diet, my workout pattern, how I manage stress, and all of these areas come together to support my life. So it's not just one thing. It's not just Pilates. It's not just eating healthy. It's not just stress management. It's really all of these come together to lift me up, to elevate what I feel is my best life at this point in time. Wherever you are, I encourage you to evaluate what works for you right now. And what works for you right now may be a little bit different than in the future, and that's perfectly acceptable. We really want to honor where we are right now, respect what we need right now, and we can continue to make small changes, sometimes larger changes, to support our needs in the future. And with that, I hope that you have a beautiful day and can join me for another vlog soon.
Don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell notification. And like, share, and leave me a comment.